Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Double S, a company selling lights on Amazon, offered to send me one of their Sound Active RGB LED strip light kits in hopes that I can use it in a video. Having in mind a fun project I could use it for, I accepted. This kit contains 32.8 feet or 10 meters of LED strip lighting, along with a controller, power brick, and remote. I also needed a 12-volt power bank and barrel plug cord, so I purchased those and had them handy. The first step to making this light-up vest was to unroll the strip and peel off the sticky backing. Although it looked easy at first, I later found out that it was going to be a bit of a challenge to remove, not because it was stuck to the strip, but because the foam backing was breaking off as I was trying to peel it back. I later found out that pushing it back with my thumb was a more effective way of removing it while leaving less residue. Turning the LED strip on at full power helped warm and soften the sticky backing so I could remove the stuck together strips. After several minutes of doing this, I finally freed the LED strip of its sticky backing. Now that I'm done with that sticky mess, let's open the vest and start lining the LED strip for the right arm. I decided to pin this strip so I know exactly the length I'd need when I cut it. Now that everything is lined up, let's cut it. Make sure I line it up. And... oop! Let's try that again. Oh well, that didn't work. Clearly scissors are the wrong tool to be cutting the LED strips with. Let's try these. There we go. Much better. Next, I remove the pins and lined up the cut strip with the end of the remaining roll. Now I have two equal length strips for both of my arms. To attach the controller, I simply sew it to my vest by routing the thread through the two screw holes. I mounted the controller inside the vest under the right arm with the sensor and one connector hanging out the bottom, while the other one turns around to connect to the LED strip. The beginning of the LED strip was not long enough to reach the controller, so I cut off the connector, and with a little bit of soldering, extended the length to reach the controller. Before I begin sewing it onto the vest, I decided to solder extension wire on the other end of the strip so I would not have to do that when it was on the vest. The rubber coating was difficult to remove, but later, I found an easier way to do it. Next, we will apply solder to the four contacts. Now we'll strip the wires and solder them to the contacts. Here's the finished connections. My soldering is not that fantastic here, but it worked perfectly and I had no issues when I used it. Now I will sew the LED strip to the inside layer of my vest by pulling the thread through the fabric, over the strip, and back into the fabric. If you happen to have a mannequin or something to put the vest on while you sew, it helps keep the fabric straight, which is important when sewing the strips on. I borrowed my sister's dress form to hold this vest and put it on inside out so it would be easier to sew. Remember when I said I found an easier way for removing the rubber coating? Well, it turns out that you can actually peel the rubber off the strip itself if you can get your nail between the strip and the rubber. Then you just pull hard to snap off the peeled section. After several hours of sewing and soldering, this is how it turned out.
Here's the finished design for the light-up vest. We first start with the battery, which then runs along a cable here and connects into the LED strip controller. Then I have the sensor hanging out the bottom, so when I'm wearing it, it can still receive the information from the remote. One of the connections here is connected to a cut and extended portion of the beginning of the first LED strip, which then comes around for the left arm, which is then soldered to this extension cable and is soldered here to the section that goes up and around the neck. Soldered to another extension, which comes around and is soldered to the strip for the right arm. That's pretty much all there is to it.
I would like to thank my sister for showing me how to hand sew and to Double S for sending me the LED strip light kit. If any of you are interested in picking up a box, I'll have the link in the description. I hope you all enjoyed this video as much as I did making the light up vest. Until next time, I'm Nate the Lighting Guy, and thanks for watching.